वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज म्यू फाज ट्रांसपोजोन्स और द बैक्टेरियोफाज म्यू ट्रांसपोजोन्स। बिफोर दैट लेट अस रिवाइज द पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, दैट इज द व्हाट इज मोबाइल डीएनए एलिमेंट्स और ट्रांसपोजोन्स। सो ट्रांसपोजोन्स आर डीएनए सीक्वेंसेस दैट कैन मूव अराउंड टू डिफरेंट पोजिशंस within the genome of a single cell, and the process is called as transposition. So you know transposons are nothing but the DNA sequences that can change their position within the genome, or they can move from one location to another, and that transformation is called as the transposition, right? So these movable or the mobile genetic elements of chromosome that can move from one location to another within the genome. So they are movable or the mobile, that's why they are called as the mobile DNA elements. And the general features of transposable elements. First, they can cause mutations and change the amount of DNA in the genome. By inserting themselves to the genome or within the genome, they can change or alter the DNA sequence so that the amount of DNA that also get changed with the help of copy and paste mechanism, right? Means they make their own copy and then they get inserted into the another site. So the copy number of DNA that get increases. Transposons are also called as jumping genes or the junk DNA or the mobile DNA elements, right? There are many types of mobile genetic elements, and they can be grouped based on their mechanism of transposition. So on the basis of the transposition mechanism, they grouped on the basis of that, right? So transposable mobile elements make genetic changes and having important contribution to the evolution of genome. So by causing the mutation or altering the gene sequence, they contribute to the evolutionary mechanism. Okay, so they are responsible for the evolution of genomes of various organisms. Transposons are divided into three general classes. First is the compound or composite that include TN5, TN10 and TN7. Then class 2, that is the more complex, and that includes TN3. And the last one, that is the class 3, that is bacteriophage mu and the related phages, on which we are going to focus today. So the types of transposons, so main two types are there. Class 1 is the composite or the retrotransposons, and the mechanism of transposition is the copy and paste mechanism. So these retrotransposons or the composite transposons copy themselves and paste copies back into the genome anywhere. So they copy themselves and they get change or they get pasted into the another location within the genome. So these retrotransposons copy themselves to RNA with the help of the transcription mechanism, but in advance to being transcribed, the RNA get copied into DNA by the reverse transcriptase enzyme, which is coded by the transposon, right? So that is the mechanism of retrotransposons, and it get inserted back into the genome and anywhere in the genome, right? So retrotransposons behave very likely or very similar to the retroviruses, such as HIV, giving a clue to the evolutionary origin of such a viruses. Means there are many similarities between the retroviruses and HIV here. There are three main classes of retrotransposons, but today we are going to see the viral retrotransposons for the mu bacteriophage transposon, which encodes reverse transcriptase, that is to reverse transcribe RNA into DNA. So they make DNA of the RNA, DNA copy of this RNA, and have long terminal repeats that are LTRs and that are very similar to the retroviruses. So come to this bacteriophage mu, that is also known as mu phage or the mu bacteriophage, is a mu virus of the family Myoviridae, which has been shown to cause the genetic transposition. So phage mu is a member of family Myoviridae with an icosahedral head and the contractile tail. So it is having tail, so this virus is having tail in their structure. Its genome is packed and consists of a single linear DNA molecule with about 37,000 base pair. In addition, the phage usually packages between 500 to 3000 base pair of host DNA, making phage mu a generalized transducing phage. Okay, so this is the generalized transducing phage also. So this phage mu exhibits a temperate life cycle with genome integrated into the chromosome of its host and particularly E. coli. Okay. So it is of peculiar importance as its discovery in Escherichia coli or the E. coli by the Larry Taylor was among the first observations of insertion elements in the genome. So its first discovery in E. coli bacteria by the scientist. Then this discovery has opened up the world to an investigation of transposable elements and their effects on wide variety of organism. So this is responsible for the investigation for the wide variety of organisms. While mu was specifically involved in several distinct areas of research, including E. coli, MACE and HIV, the wider implications of the transposition and the insertion transform the entire field of genetics. So the researchers are very fond of this work that includes E. coli, MACE and HIV. Mu phage played an important role in development of the mobile DNA elements category as the Barbara McClintock find a DNA elements to regulate the mosaic color patterns of maize kernels, that is the kernel seeds. So the maize kernel phage after its mutator properties. Okay. Also found its ability to suppress the phenotypic expression of genes and suggested that the mu resembled the controlling elements. Okay. She also found that the mu resembles like the controlling elements found in maize, that are AC and the DS elements. As we have already discussed about the AC and DS element in the previous lecture, right? So the mechanism of mu transposition is both supercoiled and oligonucleotide substrates. And the mu transposition has two distinct phases. First is infection phase and second is the lytic phase. So infection phase is also, you can also call it as a lysogenic phase. So during the infection phase, the mu DNA incorporated into the cell has a particular structure. Okay. So it is after integration that the mu genome displays an unusual alternate mode of movement, that is acting as a transposon that moves from one location to another in the host genome. So it can do this in a non-replicative manner or a replicative manner but here for the lysogenic it is the non-replicative manner. Okay, so it can utilize the replicative transport mode, and the second copy of genome transposon is then created at the second location for the lytic phase. Okay, so this phage mu is not unique in this dual existent, but mu-like prophage have been found in another bacteria, including Pseudomonas, Haemophilus influenza, Neisseria, and the bacteria like this. Okay. So this DNA is a linear in the phage heads first. So the phage contain the linear DNA in his head and flanked by the non-mu host DNA acquired during the packaging of integrated mu replicas during the lytic cycle in a prior host. Okay, so initially it is a single stranded DNA when it get incorporated into the bacterial genome, but there are some specificity or peculiarities of this virus, we'll see later. So it is around 60 to 150 base pair of host sequence flanked the left L for left end of mu and 0.5 to 3 kilo base pair flank the right or the R end, R for the right end. Mu sequences are about 300 base pair repeated 3 lakhs to 5 lakhs times in the human genome, and that is up to 3% of the total human DNA. So the total human DNA that contain around 3% of the mu DNA. The sequences are divergent, related, but not identical. So the mu phage contain the related sequences, means very similar sequences, but they are not identical. Again, each mu sequence is flanked by 7 to 20 base pair direct repeats at its end. Okay, so they contain direct repeat at the ends. At least a few mu sequences can be transcribed, and mu sequences are retrotransposons that move by the RNA intermediate formation, that is the copy and paste mechanism, and the mechanism is the retrotransposons mechanism that form the reverse transcriptase and make DNA copy of the RNA, and then they form copy of themselves and get inserted or paste into the genome. An integrated phage protein N binds to the tip end of the flanking DNA, that is denoted as FD. FD for flanking DNA. So these N proteins are present at both end of the mu bacteriophage genome, which are for the protection from the degradation, while also converting the linear genome into a non-covalently closed supercoiled structure prior to the integration into the host chromosome. So these N proteins are responsible for the formation of non-covalently closed supercoil structure. Okay, in upcoming figure we'll see in detail, right? The mu flanking DNA will be referred to as FD, as just we have discussed, FD for the flanking DNA, irrespective of whether the donor substrate is phage, prophage, or plasmid or oligonucleotide. Okay, so irrespective of all these, the flanking DNA are present at the ends. During the lytic phase, now come to the lytic phase, that is the second phase, mu behaves as a part of large covalently closed circular host genome. Thus, the donor mu DNA configuration into the infection phase is different from that during the lytic phase. So we'll see the difference with the help of figure. So in both phases, the mechanism of mu transposition is the same, or similar. The transposase mu A initially generates a pair of water-mediated endonucleolytic cleavages on specific mu host phosphodiester bonds, producing a 3-OH nick at mu DNA ends. Okay, so this endonucleolytic activity leads to the formation of 3-OH, and this OH which is useful for attacking the target site. In the subsequent strand transfer, that is the ST, that is called as strand transfer step, the 3-OH ends directly attack the phosphodiester bond in the target DNA, but spaced 5 base pair apart. So this OH, which is get formed by the nucleolytic attack, that cleaves the target site but away from the 5 base pair. Okay. This reaction is intermolecular in the infection phase. So infection phase, the reaction is intermolecular, where in the lytic phase it is intramolecular. So this is the main difference between the lytic and lysogenic. So the intermolecular and the intramolecular phase is there. So mu ends join 5-phosphorus in the target, leaving phosphodiester bond in the target and leaving the 3-OH nicks on the target. The mu B protein is essential for the efficient capture of the target but plays critical role at the stages of transposition by allosterically activating mu A. So this mu gene is responsible, or it allosterically activates the mu A. The cleavage and the strand transfer reactions, also called phosphoryl transfer reactions, are common to another DNA transposition systems, including retroviral integration. So this cleavage and strand transfer reaction are the important phases in the lytic and the infection phase. So here, with the help of diagram, you can clearly understand the difference between the infection phase and the lytic phase of the mu bacteriophage. Here in this figure, you can see the mu bacteriophage genome, which includes the flanking DNA, which is indicated by the light sky blue color, and the mu phage DNA in black color. So the cleavage of the mu phage in two fashion, or it is having two different phases. First is the lytic phase and second is the infection phase. So let's first discuss about the infection phase. Here in this figure A, you can see the bacteriophage mu gene, which is protected by the N proteins. As we have discussed about the N proteins, they are for the protection from the degradation of mu bacterial macrophage genome. So here you can see the 3-AC, which on the proteolytic or the endonucleolytic cleavage leads to the formation of OH, or the 3-OH, and this 3-OH is directly attacking to the target site of bacteria. Here you can see in the red color target site. Okay, and this is the second step, and the it is called as strand transfer reaction, as we have just discussed about this strand transfer. So during this strand transfer, it forms the theta like structure. In upcoming diagram, we'll see the how theta get formed during this strand transfer reaction. So look at this strand transfer reaction. In this figure, you can see the N protein binding region is nicked by this OH group, and again this N binding protein, that is the flank DNA, it get removed by the help of the flap endonuclease activity. Okay, so here the removal of flanking DNA is there, where in the lytic cycle you can see the mu GNA is integrated as a part of the covalently supercoiled structure. Okay, and then it forms and this OH group, and this OH group then attacks the target DNA within the bacterial genome, and then the strand transfer reaction get occurs. And after strand transfer reaction, the second reaction is the replication. Okay, so this is the replication reaction where these two parent strand get separated and their separate replication occurs, right? So here in this figure you can clearly understand the theta formation during this strand transfer. So in this figure, firstly you can see in red color mu phage, and the black color is the host chromosome or the bacterial chromosome. Then nicking at the 3' OH ends, that leads to the target site cleavage, right? And the strand transfer reaction, here you can see the theta formation, right, at the second step. Then the replication by the host factors, and here the in the lysogenic phase deletion of products, that is the deletion of flanking DNA is there. And in the lytic cycle, that theta formation that get resolved by the resolvase enzyme, okay, and then replication occurs and the bacteriophage mu protein get formed with the help of translation process, and the whole bacteriophage or the virion particle get produced and burst out of the cell to infect the another bacteria. So this is the life cycle or the phases of the mu bacteriophage. So these retrotransposons also appear to be present in mammals. For example, a very abundant human sign repeats, that is the short interspersed nuclear sequences, is the mu family only. Okay. So a human case of genetic diseases. So the genetic diseases regarding the mu phage, that are the neurofibromatosis, that provide some evidences, like a neurofibromas, that is the tumor like growth on the body, results from an autosomal dominant mutation. Okay, so these are some diseases regarding the mu phage. And in patients' DNA, an unusual mu sequence was detected in one of the introns of the neurofibromatosis genes. So these are some findings regarding the patient survey. Then the resulting longer transcript is incorrectly processed, and removing an exon from mRNA and producing the non-functional protein. So this is the main mechanism for the disease formation, where the longer transcript they get incorrectly processed and the exon get removed from the mRNA, and this leads to the non-functional proteins. So neither parent had this mu sequence in the fibromatosis gene. So this is particularly because of the incorrect processing. Okay. So the divergent mu sequences made it possible to track this particular version to an insertion event in the germline of the patient's father. Okay. So this tracking is possible through the survey of patients regarding the mu bacteriophage diseases. Okay. So these are the references for this topic. I hope you understand the lecture, and thank you for listening.